The left cares about gays, and the right eats homophobic chicken. Hey, it's Prince of Queens, and due to International Men's Day being a few days ago, we should most definitely remember that gay men are not really included, because International Men's Day is some sort of MRA thing, and as I've been told hundreds of times, feminism is the real movement that cares about equality for gay men. Because, well, alright, gays might not get a whole lot in return, but we do have to stand with our sisters because they were there to nurse me back to health when I almost died of AIDS. Surely I jest, not because gay men aren't men and therefore should have every reason to celebrate International Men's Day. However, why settle for this sorry excuse for a celebration when if we decided that maybe we weren't really men and that maybe we're non-binary or something, the left might start to care about us a whole lot more? I mean, the left owns gay men after all, so we should at least try to win their favor. However, while it's not the least bit difficult to find feminists and even LGBT publications scolding gay men for our more masculine ways, none of that matters anymore when there's somebody, something, or a business that we can at least call homophobic. And then everything changes as the left will swoop on in to save us with very useful outrage that we should be very grateful for. On the one hand, the dramatic majority of issues that tend to affect straight men, such as genital mutilation, suicide without gender-specific mental health care, higher rates of violence, being penalized by affirmative action even though we're a minority, lack of social services, and so many more things, well, these are issues that affect gay men and straight men alike.
Just in 2012, they did a survey, and this is the National Crime Victimization Survey. So it requires a male victim to identify what happened to him as rape, which is difficult for male victims to do because we live in a society that says men can't be raped. And 38% of the victims of rape were found to be men. On a National Crime Victimization Survey, which required them to say, yeah, I was a victim of rape.
In order to approach any solutions or even help around such issues, we'd first need to acknowledge these issues in the first place, and obviously in order to do that, we'd first have to acknowledge the universality of male issues, which is something that the gay media and activist industry is not exactly ready to do, as they're firmly aligned with the feminist movement, and so we're stuck complaining about chicken sandwiches. Or how the business selling them spends its money. Obviously, this is a minuscule consolation prize that's a sorry excuse for actually giving a crap about the dramatic majority of male and thus gay male issues, but let's be clear, it's been this way since the men's rights movement began. Unfortunately, some of the blame for this disconnect of gay issues and male issues, and dare I say blame in as non-confrontative as I can of a way, doesn't necessarily come from gay men's disinterest in allying with men, who are the single population that shares most of our issues, nor from an overbearing and evangelical feminist movement. Rather, although I don't think that it was ever the intention of straight men to deliberately leave gay men out of the men's rights movement, the origin of the current men's movement was fostered in the struggle of men going through particularly challenging marriages, divorces, fathers' rights, and men trying to avoid prison for allegations leveled by their wives or girlfriends. And so, homosexual men were less excluded by heterosexual men in most respects during the early years of the MRM, but more forgotten about, making it less challenging for the feminist movement to begin moving in on the fledgling gay rights movement, as the man described in the essay first delivered at the Gay Academic Union Conference in 1977, Dangerous Trends in Feminism. Now, granted, as highlighted in the essay, there was some resistance to the feminist strong-arming of the gay community after feminists went too far and demanded even back then that male-attracted men give up their struggles like the abolition of sodomy laws in favor of smashing the patriarchy, which was not welcomed with entirely open arms. However, from everything I've pieced together from my examination into the historical trajectory of feminism, men's rights, and gay men's rights, after some time, the homosexual male population was crippled by AIDS, by and large, leaving the population both weak and in need of help. Now, the next part is a bit hazy, and I imagine it will always be a bit hazy, because, as we all know, a massive percentage of homosexual men who were actively engaged in their own communities ended up dying, or at least came extremely close to dying. And while feminists will eagerly claim now that they basically nursed every dying gay man through the crisis that managed to survive, which apparently is why we still have gay men at all, I've heard some very conflicting stories. Some say that it was the sole work of lesbian feminists that were responsible for the fact that not every gay man died, as if lesbian and feminist is an entirely synonymous concept. Others have explained to me that the early feminist movement was entirely reluctant to do anything about this gay male issue, as the lesbians who did care for dying gay men were the mere exceptions to a general trend of feminist neglect. I've also found examples like this Christian woman, who was famous for nursing a massive amount of gay men during the peak of the crisis. I imagine that all things probably have some truth to them, and honestly, I think it's probably the safest way to view it. It would probably be both unfair to give lesbian feminists as a population either too much credit or no credit at all. I'm not really going to argue one way or the other. However, what did clearly happen was that by the time the greater community of everybody who was non-straight became an actual movement, starting first as GLBT and then shifting to LGBT very quickly, there was an unignorable feminist element within both the greater LGBT and movement at large.
To me, there's only one word. It's gay. Lesbians and gays, as far as in my book, you know, through all the years that I've been in the movement, I've always had the respect for the lesbians and whatnot, but Randy, you and I both know that when the Stonewall Rebellion started and the Stonewall Riots started, there were no gay women that were arrested. And why lesbians have to be put in front of the word gay when we're all gay.
During and after the Reagan years, as the overtly Christian religious right dominated the Republican Party and right-wing politics, it undoubtedly didn't even seem like a possibility that gay men might ever consider aligning with conservative politics. And really, it stayed that way all through the 80s, 90s, 2000s, and has only begun to change with the advent of the Trump takeover of the Republican Party, which people could safely say many things about, such as unusual, unexpected, and drastic. But here's the question that I find myself repeatedly asking, or rather, perhaps the observation I keep mentioning. What have the Democrats and the left done for gay men lately? I mean, surely, in order for any population of people to stay interested in pledging allegiance to a party or political alignment, they have to occasionally do something that helps them and maybe doesn't criticize them at every turn. Unfortunately, to be truthful, aside from persecuting a small few Christian or Catholic-headed adoption organizations, which might not take gays and lesbians as clients, but I guess it's never actually come up in numerous cases, making sure that gay marriage stays legal, even though it already is, and stuff like healthcare, which the Democrats apparently plan on offering to literally everybody, including illegal immigrants, Well, the only thing I ever see the leftist media ever mention about homosexuality is the times in which they call people homophobic. With all of that being said, it's been continually frustrating to me since long before starting my channel just how absent gay men have been from essentially every conversation about sex, gender, or even LGBT issues at large, both from the left, who spends seemingly a lot more time complaining about us, as well as from some of the new right, who seem eager to belittle gay men once political correctness stopped being cool. I do just mean the citizens. Now, I'll definitely say that the overall mainstream message from the right is a lot more positive regarding gay men, especially considering the fact that gay Republicans were once but a small pocket of politically obscure individuals that nobody really ever encountered. I have to say, when it comes to the issues that really tend to affect the lives of gay men by and large, neither party is really talking about them a great deal. And by those issues, I mean men's issues, like those brought up in the greater men's movement, as a focus on both the gender-specific issues of men and boys that take specific note of the fact that our entire society is built around untrue and harmful feminist assumptions and should be acknowledged as the first step towards something bigger and then dissolved. I mean, granted, the White House just finally started a council for men and boys, but have they actually done anything yet? And how do we ensure that it isn't taken over by some feminists like everything else of its type? We will have to wait and see. Gay men of today owe nothing more to contemporary lesbians and feminists than they owe to mere Christians, who honestly have participated in every bit as much charity work that might benefit gay men in the grand scheme of things, probably a fair amount more. Even more so, while there is an argument to be made that there's been some actively anti-gay Christian lobbyists in the past, certainly, there's also been actively anti-gay feminists who've legally harmed all men, including gay men. Personally, I run into those types today a lot more than I ever even hear of homophobic Christians. In summary, if gay men have literally any interest in attempting to help or solve gay men's issues pragmatically, I think the only logical thing to do would be to remember the issues of International Men's Day and remember all of the issues that unite us with our straight brothers, because our fate is much more closely aligned with theirs than ours aligns with women's issues, trans issues, and the issues that the leftist media outrage machine chooses out for us whenever they're on a slow day. Happy International Men's Day, homos. Don't forget what you are. Alright, that's all I had to say for this video. If you would like to donate to me, you can do that on Subscribestar or on PayPal. I'd really appreciate it for the holidays. Thanks a bunch.